pitting workers against each other, pitting people against each other, is the core of Republican electoral strategy going back to the 60s. Check this out, leave your comments, ding the bell, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel. This is a problem. Dan in Altoona, Pennsylvania. Hey, Dan, what's up?
Hey, Tom. Hey, I just wanted to make a little comment about the guy that you guys had to bail on, that was the Trump supporter, and where he was going with what he was talking about. I've heard that song and dance pretty much every week, because I live in a rural area of Pennsylvania. He was starting up with, I make $600 a month, and he was going to continue going on about how the unemployed, the people that were going to get help with the pandemic response would be making more money than him. And that is a huge deal to these people. I don't know when it happened, but we got away from society on the right, and they have become individuals and become incredibly selfish. And that
this goes back to the 80s, Dan. No, this is one of the core conservative memes. It literally goes back to the 80s. And this was Ronald Reagan's pitch to destroy unions. He would speak to non-union people, not specifically him, but the whole right-wing machine, would speak to non-union people and say, those union guys are making more than you, and it's not fair. We need to break up their union. And so it was pitting worker against worker and using basically envy, class envy, wealth envy, whatever you want to call it, as the device. And they did it that with worker against unions. Back in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, they were telling white people, black people are coming. Actually, in the 50s through the 70s, the big backlash to the women's movement was they were telling white men, white women are coming for your jobs. Then it became black people are coming for your jobs. Then it became, oh my God, the Hispanics are coming for your jobs, which has been, Donald Trump's primary sales pitch. And now it's, oh my God, somebody on unemployment is making more money than you are on Social Security. And in every case, it's like this let's all share in grievance. Oh my God, somebody else is doing well and I'm not doing so well. So rather than lifting me up, rather than raising Social Security benefits, let's cut their benefits. Sorry, Dan, I jumped in on top of you, but you can finish your thought now.
No, you answered it perfectly. I was going to say that, until we can fix the issue of, getting back into like a societal type of, thought process, I don't know how much good we can possibly do. We need to all work together. And as of right now, it doesn't seem like it's possible.
Yeah, and we need to be calling that very, very selfish, very, kind of class warfare kind of language out, too. Dan, thank you.